Hello, welcome to a Monday edition of The Voice of ocala. Buddy Martin with you again this week. Glad to be back with you, as we are every weekday, right here 3 to 6 on The Source, and of course Saturday mornings from 10 to 11 on Buddy Sports Page. Today, news not so good. We're still scrambling to find out the details of the shooting at the Naval Base in Washington. Tom will have the inside story here, and as much as we know it, with 12 dead, including the gunman, and this is something that seems to grow in horror as the hours pass by. And not sure who the gunman was. ABC News, I think, just reported it was a former naval officer that was shot and killed, but details are sketchy. Don't know much about that, so we'll get right to that in a moment. There was a brief bullet on my screen, on my computer, that they've ID'd a name of a suspect, but it came down, so maybe somebody decided it might not be accurate. So in these times, lots of information and misinformation gets out there. Networks scrambling all day since 8:20 this morning to figure out what has happened at that shooting in Washington, D.C. Today on the program, we'll tell you about the big doings at the Marion Theater next couple of weeks. We'll bid goodbye to Newsroom for a while.
Great show last night, by the way.
It was. And I got my take on the series. And also, don't ask me why, but I watched Breaking Bad last night for the first time. So, and Tom will tell us about the culture he's gaining these days. He went to see Les Mis. He'll tell us later. Right now, he's here to tell us about what's the latest information we have on the Washington shooting.
Well, buddy, what we know is the Navy first reported, and this is the times we live in, via Twitter, that there was an active shooter at Building 197 at the Navy Yard, and shots have been fired around 8:20 a.m. Eastern Time. We know that there have been 12 total deaths reported. That's according to the Washington Metropolitan Police Chief, Kathy Lanier. This includes the shooter. The number of injuries is not confirmed. Aaron Alexis is confirmed by an FBI source to the AP and to USA Today as the shooter. He is a retired naval officer.
So it's not obviously a terrorist.
No, Aaron Alexis.
At least not a foreign terrorist.
Right. Yeah. The Chief of Police, Kathy Lanier, Washington Metropolitan Police Chief Kathy Lanier, said police are searching for two more people, a white male wearing a tan military-style uniform, but that has later been rescinded, saying that they found that person and that person was not involved in the shooting or is not a person of interest. They're still searching for a black man around 50 wearing an olive military-style uniform and carrying a long gun. They don't know if he was part of this or not, but they want to talk to him as a person of interest to see what he was doing in the area at the time. Federal officials said that they only believe right now the dead gunman fired weapons in the attack, but they're looking at surveillance video. If you're wondering where Building 197 is, that's the Naval Yard Systems Command Headquarters. It's in Building 197 in the Navy Yard. This headquarters is a workplace for about 3,000 people. The Sea Systems Command is responsible for engineering, building, buying, and maintaining ships. So,
2.6 miles from the White House.
Right.
So, you've heard this long gun thing mentioned a couple of times today. That's a new term. I haven't been hearing that before.
Well, the fallout from this is the area around the Naval Yard has shelter-in-place orders. Marine Barracks in Washington is on lockdown. Washington Nationals game against the Braves. Nobody knows whether that's going to happen or not. Flights in and out of Reagan National were stopped this morning, but they have resumed as of 1 p.m. this afternoon. So, and a lot of schools around the area are on lockdown. So this is a serious situation in Washington, D.C.
I'd say it's more than serious. It's a travesty. I think I heard today that only Fort Hood with 13 people killed was the largest military domestic slaying of people. So it makes you wonder how it could happen, who would do it, and why, and so on and so forth. And at a time when Americans are obviously, you know, trying to defend Americans everywhere, especially abroad, while Americans would kill Americans, and what would possess someone to do this?
Well, the president said he was going into a meeting this morning, but he made some remarks and said, these are men and women, military and civilian, that are assigned the duty of protecting us, and some coward attacked them. We'll go through all the levels of law that we need to make sure that these people are brought to justice.
Yeah. We'll keep you on top of that as we get news. We'll pass along to you. Meanwhile, we have a lot of things to cover today, which we'll talk about in the upcoming segment. We mentioned the television shows. Goodbye to the newsroom. The last show of this season, and who knows how much longer, it was last night. We'll comment on that, tell you what I like about it. Tom will tell us about Les Mis. Quite a football weekend. Obviously, on our air here, you heard the Seminoles prevailing big time over Nevada. We've got the game of the century, which turned out to be a very good football game, by the way. I might surprise you with what I say about Johnny Manziel. I've got a few thoughts on that. NFL was kind of crazy. The Bucs find a new way to lose again. We had some upsets. We had some interesting games. The Buffalo Bills pull one out. JJ's happy. JJ's hot right now. His teams are winning. I don't know what he's doing, but you got to be happy with
Sitting hot over here, too.
Yeah. Got to move you around over here, JJ. The thing is that E.J. Manuel has really proven to be quite a pickup for the Bills.
And, awesome, buddy.
Yeah, really, really.
I'm all in.
Yeah, how about that? You pulling for a no. I can't believe it. Hey, there you go.
Sometimes you got to do it.
There you go. Also, later on in sports, a legendary Gator is dead. A guy, arguably one of the top four or five athletes in the history of the school. We'll talk to Hubert Mizell of TB20 later on about that, along with Franz Beard. Speaking of football, big win for the UCF Knights at Happy Valley. And just out of curiosity, some people talk about in sports, how good is Peyton Manning? How good is he when you all boils down, how good is he in terms of where will be his place in history? He looks very good right now. Of course, he's getting up there. He can get dinged up pretty fast, and things can change. All that coming up next. Stay tuned. We've got information for you on the shooting. We'll tell you a little more about the Marion Theater situation, talk about Newsroom, and maybe even Breaking Bad. And Tom, the Dow, takes over for the Culture Vulture. We'll tell you about Les Mis, all coming up next, right here. And by the way, today is Monday, and Dr. Buddy will be in the house. All coming to you right here on the program, The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
This is Ocala's Chief of Police, Greg Graham, answering one caller's question.
How often are the officers required to go to the firing range to keep their shooting skills up to par?
Great question. By FDLE rules, they're supposed to go once a year. We actually do, the police department does two qualifications a year, and then throughout the year we have practice days and sessions with them. But I tell you, the problem that we're having a difficult time getting ammo or enough ammo to have those practice days. But we do a minimum of two qualifications a year.
That reprise of Ask the Cops was proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. Be sure to tune in to Ask the Cops the second and fourth Friday of every month during the 4 o'clock hour on the Voice of Ocala.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the Voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
Go! WOCA.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Are you wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on termite retreat fees? If you're not with Turner Pest Control, you probably are. Turner Pest Control offers the industry's only termite and pest control package that never charges retreat fees, ever. You can get started today for only $99. This is a value of $500 or more. This includes treatments, installation of monitoring stations, quarterly pest control, and a lifetime guarantee, all for an unbelievable low $99. Even if you have another pest control provider, visit turnerpest.com to find out how you can avoid paying those high termite retreat fees.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're ocalaforsale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to ocalaforsale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
The Corkscrew Winery in downtown Ocala is having a grape stomp Saturday, September 21st from 5 to 7 p.m. The cost is only $25, and that includes the grape stomp experience, a glass of wine, and light finger food. Plus, you bottle and take home a finished wine. The Corkscrew Winery is located at 16 Southwest Broadway in historic downtown Ocala. Space is limited and reservations are required, so call today, 352-402-0158. That's 352-402-0158.
No. And I just need one.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala. I'm Tom Schmidt for this update from the Washington Navy Yard shootings. Details surrounding the Naval Yard shootings are still developing, but here's the breakdown of facts according to the FBI so far. The Navy first reported it via Twitter that there was an active shooter in Building 197 around 8:20 Eastern. There have been 12 confirmed deaths, according to Washington Metropolitan Police Chief Kathy Lanier. That does include the dead shooter. The number of injuries is still unknown at this time. Aaron Alexis is confirmed as the shooter by an FBI source. Aaron Alexis is a retired naval officer. The Washington Police Chief Kathy Lanier says police are searching for two more possible shooters, but that has since been updated that the white male wearing a tan military style uniform with short sleeves has been found, vetted, and not a person of interest and not involved. They are still searching the Naval Yard as we speak. The Naval Yard is on lockdown. The schools around the area are on lockdown. Reagan International Airport was on lockdown, but now flights have resumed since 1 p.m. Once again, 12 total deaths reported, according to Washington Metropolitan Police Chief Kathy Lanier. Aaron Alexis is the confirmed shooter by an FBI source. And this all started around 8:20 this morning in Building 197, buddy.
All right, thanks, Tom. Coming up in sports, we'll talk about one of the great Gators passing away, arguably one of the top five athletes of all time. Hubert Mizell will be our guest from TV 20. And we'll recap the weekend's games, college and pro. Meanwhile, today's thoughts, just a couple little thoughts, and we have Dr. Buddy coming up later. We also have faked or fact, our factoids, which we mix in a couple of fakes, let the guys guess at which one they are. And Tom will tell us about his insight on the Charlie Rose interview, which is replayed with Assad, was replayed on 60 Minutes last night, and a comment that was made afterward by an FBI official. Meanwhile, here's a couple thoughts. Number one, respect your parents. They pass school without Google. Isn't Google a great thing? I was just told my wife this morning, just going through it. I said, you know, isn't Google great? I mean, my gosh, it's such a source. And especially if you don't have quite the memory you had when you were 21 years old. We all have a little slippage there. So, also the second one, this will be one, this is for you, Tom. Okay. This is a little, I should have said, saved this later on for our quips and quotes, but I thought it was pretty good. I got to read it. She was Hannah Montana when Bush was president. Thanks, Obama.
Yeah, I really like that.
I figured you'd like that. You liked the interview last night with Charlie Rose, too, and we'd seen parts of that on the networks prior to 60 Minutes, and you were struck by something that was said after that, and I kind of wondered myself a little bit about who are these rebels, and you had an insight on that.
Yes, I did. I was watching last night as Charlie Rose interviewed President Assad from Syria, and the two things that struck me about the interview is, one is Assad is very well-spoken, and two is Assad said that the rebels, if you want to back the rebels, you want to back al-Qaeda. And I thought, back al-Qaeda? There's no way we're backing a group that is al-Qaeda. So I watched the whole interview, and Assad, you know, he comes across as a very, very cold and calculated person who I believe would stop at nothing to keep what he duly thinks is his because of his family and his heritage.
His father, yeah.
Right. And even said his father had done some atrocities. And Charlie Rose said, would you do the same thing if it would get the ends that you needed? And he said, I learned from my father. So he's an evil man. That's not, mm-hmm. I don't doubt that. And he even made a threat that when you saw the President Obama did an interview 3 days after this interview, and Scott Pelley asked President Obama, did you feel like when he said, if America strikes, remember that for every strike you do, we'll strike back. Us and our allies will strike back somewhere.
There'll be a consequence.
Right. Yeah. We'll strike back somewhere at some time. It may not be immediate, but it's coming. And he said, did you take that as a threat? And Obama was like, how could you not take it as a threat? I thought that immediately.
But he also said he ain't got the firepower to do much about
it. No, but it would have to be Iran or Hezbollah.
Yeah.
And because when we're talking about Syria here, you got to keep in mind Iran and Hezbollah in Syria are the same thing. Syria's a puppet Hezbollah and Iran.
They're colleagues.
Right. So I took him threatening America. That takes a special, unique person to threaten the United States like that. But then after that interview, they had an interview with Deputy CIA Director Michael Morrell, who had just retired 6 days before the sarin gas story broke. And as deputy director of the CIA, he runs the day-to-day operations of the CIA. And he said, when asked by Scott Pelley if what Assad said was true, that to back the rebels is to back al-Qaeda, he said, well, the rebels are a bunch of different groups. But the two most effective military groups that are part of the rebels are both, and that get the most done and have the best training and the best weapons and all, and have accomplished the most in Syria in this war, are both al-Qaeda groups. So if for some reason the rebel, we get behind the rebels, then we got the chance that al-Qaeda, being they're the two strongest groups of the rebels, would take over the country. We'd have an Afghanistan again. So this whole Syria thing is, which devil do you side with, I think? And I don't think either result is conducive to America accomplishing very much, because you got this monster who's killing children with mustard gas, with sarin gas or whatever, and doesn't seem to be too upset that he's doing it because that's how he learned from his father. And on the other hand, the rebels, the two biggest and well put together groups, are both al-Qaeda based. So what are we doing in Syria with...
And who are we supporting?
Exactly.
That's confusing. You can't tell the players, you know? You don't know if half of what you're sending over there in weapons or money goes going into the hands of al-Qaeda. You wind up what you did in Afghanistan. You actually wind up arming the other side. Because
right.
At one point in time, you know, we were on one side, then we switched over, and then they were using our weapons against us. So it's very confusing. I agree with you. Assad, for being the evil man that he is pretty impressive when he stands in there and
talks.
Well,
yeah, when you hear him talk, he's an impressive orator.
And I don't buy it, but I'm just saying, he says, well, you have terrorists in America. We have terrorists here. And Charlie Rose said, well, they're not really terrorists. And that's when Assad said, well, you know, they're like al-Qaeda. And there are, Americans admit, there's some pockets of al-Qaeda and other evil forces and the rebels.
Right, so, and that's what he says. He's fighting as terrorists. Yeah. He's not fighting. He said, we're not fighting a civil war. The rebels that originally went against us are now with us.
Yeah.
And I don't buy that for a second.
Yeah, so it's very confusing. It really is. So good thoughts. Okay, Well, speaking of sarin gas, that first came up in a show called Newsroom. And it played the Genoa Project. And last night was the eighth and final program of the year, the Newsroom. I have a few thoughts on that because I watched them all. I actually got HBO just because of Newsroom. I think you kind of got hooked on it too, but I wanted to talk about, you know, the brilliance of Aaron Sorkin, the writer of the show. He involves you in the flawed characters of that program. They're eccentric, they're narcissistic, neurotic, all desperate for love. They're very vulnerable, but they're also very passionate and committed to a higher cause. And it creates a workplace that we kind of all like to be a part of. You know, they're committed to what they do. And so he takes you, or Sorkin does, on a sort of a journey of twists and turns. Well, you know they're going to be 180-degree turnarounds. You know it's going to happen. But you still find yourself rooting for the obvious outcome. I mean, I knew what was going to happen in the end, but yet I somehow told myself I would believe maybe it wouldn't happen. And, of course, it all ended well last night in the final plot. But Newsroom also, for the people who like to criticize the media, and Tom, I'll get your thoughts after this, it offers you an insight into an industry which comes off, you know, as arrogant, but at the same time, this show makes it so humanistically impaired. And really, you're thinking, these guys are probably not even capable of ordering a pizza with the same topping on it, let alone having a conspiracy. They don't agree on anything, you know? And that's what this media that I know, and what a stellar cast, by the way. I mean, Jeff Daniels is the anchor man. Sam Waterston is the network president. Emily Mortimer, the name you can't remember, is Mac.
Mac's great.
Executive producer, although I struggle with her English accent. I got a little kick out of last night when they got a word that one of the guys couldn't understand because I have a hard time. But they had that brilliant ensemble. I mean, really, just a great. And you like her or not, Jane Fonda, she has been nominated for an Emmy in this show, this bit part. And it's my favorite HBO show of the year and one of my top favorites. And what I love about Sorkin is the heart of the show and the heart of the script and the heart of the characters and their spirit. And for me, the winning edge of that whole thing is the triumph of the spirit. I mean, the fictional people were similar to the men and women I've known in the media who are so committed, whom I've been blessed to work with in their pursuit of truth. And although that sounds corny, it's really what it is. So I'm very happy to learn, if you didn't know, that Newsroom will be back for another season.
Yes.
And even if it won't be as thick in the plot or the characters won't be as rich, my Sunday nights will be better because of Newsroom being back. Meanwhile, on the day of his Emmy nomination, Jeff Daniels, by the way, tweeted, There's a we absolutely love you and we absolutely hate you to the Newsroom, he says. And this is a stamp of approval that says we're not going anywhere and all of us want to be doing this for years. And that's the feeling you get about that the crew and the cast and also the imaginary crew as well. And by the way, Jane Fonda, Nav, also got that nomination for her role as Leona Lansing, who's the CEO. What's the name of the network?
ACN.
What does it stand for?
I have no idea.
Good trivia question. Atlantis World Media. So McAvoy News Night.
Well,
the name of the show.
The amazing thing to me is I talked to a fraternity brother of mine, Tim, this morning, and he does local news. He's a local news anchor in South Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
And we were talking about this show, and he said, I hate the show. And I was like, why? He says, because it shows me just how crazy the Newsroom really is.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, what do you mean? He said, well, when you're behind the anchor desk, you don't realize all the craziness that's going on. And then I watch the show, and I'm like, that's the same Newsroom I work in every day. And he told me that you're only as good, and I hadn't thought about this till him and I had this conversation. He said, you're only as good as your staff and producers make you. Because you're just the mouthpiece of the team. He said it really is a team effort. You're just the mouthpiece of that team. Sure, you get all the kudos and all the bad, but if somebody gives you good information, you look like a genius. If somebody gives you bad information, you look like a moron. And you have very little to do with it either way a lot of times. And I didn't realize that it worked. The realisticness, and that's Sorkin, how Sorkin does it. The realistic, and I talked to my friend that is an anchor in the newsroom, and he said he doesn't like it because it's too real to him. But I found last night the story I was chasing while they were doing the election night and everything. I was so enamored by the little small story going on about them calling Michigan early.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That's the kind of way things go like that.
And his refusal. And I knew that in the end, the lady who was doing all the
would come through,
tallying was going to be right. Yeah. And I still was like, but when he pressed that button, I was like, please, God, let her be right.
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
I know.
We know what's going to happen, but he gives us creates that. We think, oh, there's McAvoy and Mack are not going to get together. And they did it in the end. You know, we thought, oh, my gosh, you know, some of the little redhead's going to go off and, you know, and something crazy's going to happen to her.
Postal or something.
And in the end, everybody just healed up right at the end. That's the joy that Sorkin brings to you, is that in this all-callous conflict where he thinks, you know, he makes you doubt, thinking, this could happen.
He brings you right to the edge.
And he brings you to the edge. Okay, time out. Everybody, you know, it's all going to be good. And it all ends happily. And that's the joy of the show. But in terms of what it's like in the newsroom, and, you know, working a little bit in television newsrooms and working at CBS, at the broadcast center there for 3 years, it's sports, but it's the same thing. I can tell you it's amazing what happens before the light goes on. All the chaos and how got a Greg Gumbel, who you might not know that well.
I know who Greg Gumbel is.
But I mean, you don't know his background at all. I mean, you don't know who he is. I know him personally. He's a friend of mine.
Right.
And I can tell you that in the midst of chaos, Gumbel is a cool cucumber. He very much can. The red light goes on, and you'd never know just 2 seconds before that, you know, Terry Bradshaw's bumped his head on the microphone and was dizzy, which is, in fact, happened, you know. And the things are going behind the scene. And then the other thing about it is that one day when I've got a slow summer day, I'm going to take you through some of the stories I've been fortunate enough to be in as a newspaper guy. It's very similar. We don't have the technology part of that with the light, but just the stories to be a part of, everything from the moon launch, you know, which I was actually covered, you know.
Right.
To going on through things that were so significant in my lifetime. And what it's – there's something about the people like that cast. They rise above themselves. They're just – it's like a great football team that suddenly finds a moment when suddenly they're better than they're capable of being. And that's the great thing about that show, that Sorkin captures that spirit in a way and humanizes them like nobody else does.
And also – something else great about that show. Remember, Jeff Daniels, who does a great job, was also once in Dumb and Dumber. I just wanted to point that out.
Yeah. He found his role. He's pretty good as an anchor man. I will say that. He's believable as an anchor man.
He is very believable as anchor man. He's pretty believable in Dumb and Dumber, too, though.
Yeah. And the other thing is that the subplots that go on around you. There's so many little stories that happen.
Well, like that girl in Washington, D.C., I was ready to smack her
smack
last
her
night.
The head.
I was ready to smack her upside the head.
I'll have her seat. I'll be sitting there doing a, you know. Yeah. Yeah, it's cool. All right, so we're glad to know the newsroom's been I'll watch a few reruns probably, but I'm glad to know it's back next year. Okay, stuff happening at the Marion Theater. A couple of things going on. I got a call today from Carmen Soto. We'll tell you about some of the early stuff on that. And also, there's a special event going to be taking place down there I think you want to hear about. So hang around. Stay tuned to The Voice of Ocala right here on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Having the motivation and making the commitment to quit smoking is a great first step towards becoming smoke-free. However, anyone who's tried to quit smoking knows how challenging it can be. Having the determination to quit may not be enough. You may need some help. If you're ready to quit smoking and are between the ages of 18 and 75, currently smoke 10 or more cigarettes a day, and can commit to participating for 24 weeks, you may be interested in a research study which is being conducted to evaluate the use of investigational drugs to see if they can aid individuals in their quest to quit smoking. To help you quit, smoking cessation counseling and all study related medical care will be provided at no extra cost. You may also be reimbursed for your travel time. To receive more information about this study, how you can participate, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research in Ocala, 352-629-5800.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
WOCA. Robin, the Marion County Literacy Council has once again nominated us to be candidates in the Kiss a Horse for Literacy campaign.
2 years ago, we sold paintings and won.
Last year, we tried to sell more paintings and lost to legendary boxer Dave Schlenker.
I think he was wrestling.
Wrestling? Boxing? What's the difference, Robin?
Well, the difference is that this year, we're busking. Busking for a bus.
Translated, that means we'll be street performing for a kiss.
A kiss with a horse.
So be sure to keep your radio tuned to WOCA The Source as we announce the different locations where you can catch us playing our accordion and mandolin on the streets.
All to help the Marion County Literacy Council teaching adults to learn how to read.
We made a website just for our campaign.
It's buskforabus.com. That's busk, B-U-S-K, then the number 4, then the letter A, and then bus with 2 S's.
Promotional consideration for the Marion County Literacy Council provided by your friends here at WOCA The Source.
96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
Life may not come with guarantees, but buying your next vehicle from Ford Lincoln of Ocala sure does. Start with their 7-day new vehicle price guarantee. If you find the identical new Ford or Lincoln vehicle anywhere else for less, Ford Lincoln of Ocala will refund you 110% of the difference. That's guaranteed. In the market for a quality pre-owned vehicle? Buy with confidence with Ford Lincoln of Ocala's 30-day pre-owned exchange policy. That's guaranteed. Ford Lincoln of Ocala's goal is to make buying your next vehicle fun, simple, fast, and guaranteed. Shop Ford Lincoln of Ocala today on North Highway 441, open 7 days a week, or shop at home at fordofocala.com. A 7-day new vehicle price guarantee, a 30-day pre-owned vehicle exchange policy. That's buying with confidence. That's buying from Ford Lincoln of Ocala. That's guaranteed. Ford Lincoln of Ocala reserves the right to verify quotes, advertised prices, 30-day pre-owned exchange policy, or 1,000 miles from date of purchase. Does not apply to vehicles sold as is. See dealer for complete details.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking the big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3 exclusively on WOCA The Source.
When I was 21, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stairs.
What a great Frank Sinatra song right there. It's, you know, the dude could sing. I listen to a lot of it on XM radio when I'm not listening to our station. And we take it for granted, but you go back to his early days as a crooner all the way through, you know, the 60s and 70s and 80s, and his quality of his voice is remarkable. I'm just coming to that late. I know he was a good singer, but the quality of his voice and the phrasing of how he sings a lyric is, he's his master, and the older I get, the more I appreciate what a great artist Sinatra was.
I just bought a week and a half ago, JJ. When did I show that to you? When I bought the 4-disc set, Sinatra Reprise. I got like 4 discs with 26 songs on each disc. I got like 100 Frank Sinatra songs now. Yeah. Got to play it in the truck right now.
I have a friend of mine who says that when you go into a legitimate Italian restaurant, you have to have a picture of Sinatra on the wall. You got to play his music, or it's not really an Italian restaurant.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with that.
Okay, so let me tell you about some things at the Marion Theater.
You want to give an update real quick on the shootings? Or
you have some information, yes. I mean, the Washington shootings, yeah, update us on what you got.
Well, the Navy first reported that it happened around 8:20, active shooter in Building 197. It is now confirmed there are 12 dead, including the shooter. The shooter has been identified as Aaron Alexis. He's a confirmed shooter by the FBI source. The FBI is now saying that the white male that they were looking for with the handgun and a military-style uniform that was thought to be a person of interest has been cleared of any responsibility. He was not responsible. They're still looking for a black male around 50 wearing an olive military-style uniform and carrying a long gun. A long gun is a sniper's rifle. A federal official said there's no evidence, though, that anyone other than the dead gunman fired a weapon during the attack. They're looking at surveillance video from Building 197 as well as other buildings around the area. But now they're saying that two of the hospitals are reporting, one hospital in the area is reporting they have three people in critical condition, but all are alert and talking. And the injuries of the three, one was shot in the leg, one was shot in the chest, and one was shot in the hand and the head. So there are three confirmed victims that are all in critical condition at a hospital close to the Navy Yard. But as of total victims still injured, there's no actual number, but these three at this hospital are suffering from gunshot wounds to the leg, gunshot wounds to the abdomen, and gunshot wounds to the hand and head.
Yeah. Okay, you know, I'm thinking, Aaron Alexis, who are you, and why did you do this? And I'm reading here on a live blog on HuffPost. Apparently, he's 34 years old. He's registered for Fort Worth, Texas. He started working at the Navy Yard as a civilian contractor, and he's the guy, apparently, who's dead. But bizarre. Bizarre story. There's just so many questions to be answered about this, and you wonder, why? And
the Washington Nationals just said that
canceled their game.
The Braves-Nats game has been canceled.
Yeah. Okay. Well, anything happens, we'll try to get that to you. You follow the Forbes list of America's richest. We'll have some little information on that coming up in a little bit. Tom, what is there about you and all of a sudden you're getting this thing for the stage and now you're becoming cultured? And, you know, you're a Georgia redneck. Let me remind you of that just so you remember, okay? And here you are going to see Les Mis. There was a time when you couldn't even spell Les Miserables.
I still can't spell it. Are you kidding me? Buddy, I saw Cats on Broadway.
Yeah. I saw it in London, by the way.
I did not. I saw it on Broadway. I've been to a Broadway show, probably six different Broadway shows in my lifetime. I've been to shows.
No, I'm only kidding.
I'm a big theater guy. I was a song and dance man in high school.
And you're a stand-up comic. Okay.
I once saw the Blue Man Group at Disney World.
Hey,
you did. You did.
JJ, you're in there, buddy. But maybe JJ should go see Les Mis.
Kudos to the Ocala Civic Theater.
Yeah.
They really, you said you went and saw ballet there?
Yes, I did. Nutcracker.
The Nutcracker that you went in?
Impressive.
You went in with, let's say, not stellar expectations?
Yeah, I didn't have a lot of expectations.
Right. I went in, a friend of mine and I went together, and she was like, how's this going to be? Les Mis in a little hick theater.
Yeah.
Both of us came out with a different perspective on the Ocala Civic Theater. Daniel Link, who plays Jean Valjean in the show, amazing. Amazing. Chip Morris, who used to do a talk show in this area, you know, he plays the husband and wife team that are the innkeepers and all that go around robbing everybody, pickpocketing and everything. Chip Morris almost steals the show in that
really?
Thing. But the guy that really was is Jonathan Leppard, an eighth grader at Howard Middle. Tears to people's eyes when he got shot on top of the barricade in Les Mis. If you know the show, which I know you do.
Don't do give it away for JJ, right. though.
But tears in the crowd, in the audience when he got shot and killed. And just an amazing, and I didn't realize that the Ocala Civic Theater, they got the moving motorized set pieces and everything. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a top-notch job they do at the Ocala Civic Theater.
No surprising, isn't it?
We're very lucky to have the caliber of theater the Ocala Civic Theater
is. That's why they're sold out most of the time. You have a hard time getting tickets.
I mean, it was packed. It was a 2 o'clock matinee, and it was standing room only. It was packed.
And you can't, you know, I mean, to pick a play would be hard to do. What would be harder than Les Mis? The intensity of the singing and all the stuff that goes on, it's a very production-oriented deal. So, obviously, the director did a heck of a job, and my friend and former
James
neighbor.
James Soar was the director.
Who?
James S-O-H-R-E.
Soar, yeah. I don't know him. But great job. I haven't seen it yet. And my friend and former neighbor, Gary Rigby, is in that. I'm not sure what role he plays, but I know he's been – they tried out – they had to have lots and lots of practices and rehearsals, naturally, to do that. So, well, it looks for – is it on? How much more – how many more times is it on?
It runs until October 13th. But the amazing thing is, buddy, the Ocala Civic Theater is one of the first nonprofit community theaters and the first in Florida that has been trusted by the New York company that owns the rights to Les Mis. Yeah. To do Les Mis. So this is the first not-for-profit theater group that's community theater group that's in impressive. The state of Florida that's been allowed to do this play.
Congratulations to folks at the Civic Theater. All right, let me tell you real quick about the other theater, the Marion. I just got a call from Carmen Soto, who does such a great job of keeping that Marion going. It's beautiful touches and little things she does out there. She called me today. She just invited me out to an event and honoring Hispanic entertainers and Hispanic culture, which I'll tell you about. We'll have her and her friend on the show Friday. It's coming up in October. They're going to have Hispanic musicians, dancers. It's going to be great. Also, get this. The Marion will host Ocala Symphony Orchestra, a smaller chamber orchestra, and they've added a special performance in the Marion on October 24th. It only got allowed 300 people to come and see it. It's called Silent Film Live Orchestra and the Greatest Vampire of All Time. I hear it's supposed to be stunning. It'll perform a special showing of the 1922 silent horror film Nosferatu. I don't know how you get Nosferatu. Nosferatu. Roger Ebert said, "The here is the story of Dracula before it was buried in cliches."
I think it's
jokes,
Nosferatu,
TV.
Buddy.
Is it?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Nosferatu?
Nosferatu, I think.
Because N-O-S, whatever it is. Nosferatu, whatever. Somebody can tell me how to pronounce it. But Roger Ebert said, "It's the story of Dracula before it was buried alive in cliches, jokes, TV skits, cartoons." Said, "The film is in awe of its material. It doesn't scare us, but it haunts us." So they're having a VIP ticket holders party, pre-party held across the street at Club Liquid, JJ's hangout, and includes appetizers, and the first drink is on them. So sounds like it's going to be terrific. We'll tell you more about it. October 24th, and the Symphony Orchestra will perform, the Chamber Orchestra will perform. That should be great. And the acoustics of the Marion, that should be terrific. So we'll tell you more about it as we find out. So stuff happening at the Marion Theater, which I, by the way, have you seen The Family yet?
I have not seen the movie, but I want to.
I got to see that. I wanted to see it last night, but I got too busy working.
Is Dr. Buddy going to be in 2 days soon?
He's in right now. Oh. He's full of basically quips.
Well, did I do a good job, Dr. Buddy, by taking a female friend of mine to see Les Mis? Was that a pretty good call?
I'd say that was an excellent call. And sometimes I think the best Dr. Buddy would say, go outside your own comfort zone to show people in a relationship you're willing to expand.
During the A&M Bama game.
During the A&M Bama game, by the way, too.
Serious. Yeah.
That's commitment.
You wouldn't catch me leaving the house if my life depended on it.
It's DVRs. But anyway, I say
Twitter ruins DVRs for football.
Not if you don't look at Twitter.
Don't look at Twitter. Just don't look at it. Anyway, good job. Dr. Buddy gives you kudos for that. But today it's mostly about tips, insights. I get a lot of requests for these little insights of things that are helpful to you. So we won't overwhelm you. We'll tell you a little bit about the female species and the difference in the two. And you'd be amazed how many words a man uses a day versus a woman. And some things not to say. And you'll be interested to know how many – you guys are good at – well, not so much Tom now that he's got a girlfriend. But you're pretty good at watching these ladies walk by out here. And these sure, attractive buddy. Ladies.
Mm-hmm. I keep it professional. I pretty much turn my back to
Yeah, them. You do. Sure, you do. Yeah, you turn your back, all right. And you hold up a sign that says, give me your number.
Well, I can see the reflection in here. Yeah. So
by the way, to be honest, my microphone points right out the window.
Yeah. So you'll be surprised. I'll tell you exactly how minutes a day an average male does that and how many women he looks at. So Dr. Buddy's got a lot of factoids today. Plus, we got factoid or fake coming up. You guys feel like you're on your game today?
I'm on it.
I don't think so. I'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll fake or factoid after this time out on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. I want to tell you about a conversation I had recently with General Manager Pat Murray on the great family atmosphere at Country Club of Ocala.
It's a family first club. Again, we have any number of different types of memberships, but obviously the one that attracts the greatest level of interest is our family. And the reason for that is we have a little bit of something for everybody. I mean, we obviously have a world-class golf course. We have 7 tennis courts here for all levels of tennis players. We have a junior Olympic size swimming pool. We have a fitness center that's second to none. And we have state-of-the-art equipment in our fitness center.
Country Club of Ocala, where the facilities are all a family would ever need. For more information, call today at 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of Monday's Gator Report and Gator Talk Thursday right here on The Source.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Swear it, Florida. It'll be partly sunny today with a shower or thunderstorm around, high 88 to 92. Partly cloudy tonight, low 71 and then 78 at the coast. Partly sunny tomorrow and becoming breezy with a shower or thunderstorm around in the afternoon, the high 86 to 90. And for Wednesday, clouds and sun with a shower or thunderstorm around during the late morning and afternoon hours, high 86 to 90. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe, and I'm your host for the new show, Damage Control, every Tuesday morning at 10:30 a.m., brought to you by Damage Control Services. We're going to be discussing floods, fires, storm and tree damage, sinkholes, mold, and many other disasters that you need to know about, how to prevent and prepare for them, as well as what to do when it happens and what to expect after it happens. This is Damage Control, Tuesdays at 10:30, right here on The Source.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details. WOCA, Ocala.
Please remember, I still want you.
It's just hard to cut that music off when you're playing Tony Bennett. People like that, it's really hard. Awesome. Okay, it is time, however, to jazz things up just a little bit here in a second. We're going to be getting to our tweets and quotes. We've moved that up and moved our fake and factoid down by popular demand. You know why? People called up and said, we don't get to hear it until we get in our car later. So I said, all right, we'll reserve it for later. We'll have it later in the show so you can get fact or a factoid or fake. You guys are pretty good. Who won last time, by the way?
I did.
Tom did. Okay. So, JJ, it's a challenge for you today. And I imagine maybe you and Austin might be in by then. Fake or factoid. Also come up in sports, we'll talk to you about a great Gator who died. We'll go over the college football and pro football weekend. Coming up next hour, Dr. Buddy joins us. here on the show. He's in the house with a few quips. Also, we'll go over the list of Forbes, list of America's riches, and all that kind of stuff coming up next hour. Meanwhile, it's time for us to do a little bit of tweets and quotes. These are choice tidbits. People think these things fall off the back of turnip trucks. They don't. We cultivate them. We mine them. We search around the world. We send our crack research team around the globe, JJ, to find these little jewels. It's like looking for diamonds in the African mines to get the kind of jewels we have for you.
Okay, you're today. Selling it a little too much.
Too much. Okay. Yeah. I'll just say they're playing great. How's that sound?
That's good.
Okay. All right, number one. You guys know who Zig Ziglar is? You ever heard that name before?
Yes.
He's a guy who's a very famous motivating guy back in the day, before my time even, on sales especially. Zig Ziglar says, you can't hit a target you cannot see, and you cannot see a target you do not have. Think about it. The famous Dale Carnegie, sir, you know what he said? Remember, happiness doesn't depend upon who you are or what you have. It depends solely on what you think. True. And finally, as long as you're in this philosophical mood, throwing out these pearl before swine today, all this great stuff, these jewels, we'll end it up with this one. It's anonymous. Life gives us all a second chance. It's called tomorrow.
Vivian Lee said something like that too, didn't she? Didn't she say, after all, tomorrow is another day?
A lot of quotes about tomorrow.
Isn't that how Gone with the Wind ended?
I can't give you that. That's I've got that stashed away in a private box someplace. The Gone with the Wind quotes don't come out right now. I'm going through my vintage list right now.
I understand.
I gave that away. I'd be giving away part of my. Do you give your answers to your trivia questions before you go do your trivia? Which, by the way, you doing tonight?
I'm doing tonight at Mojo's.
Yeah. So gave you a gratuitous plug there. So anyway, I can't tell you that. So, all right. We'll also tell you about a different kind of Miss America. Might be a little surprised about that. So stay tuned. Lots coming your way in hour two of the program called The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of Kinetic Motion Fitness here in Ocala, Florida. A lot of you have experienced our great classes and personal small group training, but did you know we now offer dynamic workouts on DVD? These high-quality, locally produced, effective DVD workouts can go where you go. Going on vacation? No problem. We can go with you. Friends and relatives out of town who are jealous that you get to come to KMF? No problem. We ship anywhere in the United States for free. Our great lineup of four DVDs includes Kinetic Achieve, Kinetic Couples, Kinetic Core, and Kinetic Campus. Four great workouts for the entire family on DVD. Sound interesting? Check them out on our website at kmfocala.com. While you're there, check out our class schedule and come see us. We're only 5 minutes from downtown across from the Skylark Plaza. Visit kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. KMF will get you results at our studio or at home with one of our DVDs. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are. Visit kmfocala.com for more information.
Requires bank approval. Vehicle purchase across the fixed rate allowance.
Yahoo! Kids are back in school and report cards are right around the corner. I've got old cars shaking in their boots because I'm flunking clunkers and junkers this month.
Hey, Professor Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. What's a smart plan to keep you from flunking out in a car that can't make the grade?
This week, trade in and save more. Get the appraised value of your old car plus up to $4,500 off a nicer, newer car.
Stuck in bad credit detention? Our For the People credit approval process wants to help everyone, even if you've been turned down before.
I vow that no car will be left behind.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales today.
Yes, during our old car report card event, you'll get up to $4,500 off a nicer, newer car, plus the appraised value of your old car. But hurry, my old car report card event ends September 30th, or after we've helped 67 students pass the test in a nicer, newer car. My name is Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, it's our business to make your business better. Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Aliens?
Yes, George. George, you're all wet.
I went to Devon's Self-Storage and put back my fishing gear.
Okay. You know Devon's Self-Storage is open early and you had all day to bring your fishing gear back, and they're right across from Hobby Lobby.
I know. I have my own code to get into Devon's Self-Storage, and their phone number, too, is 873-0777.
So why did you wait till it started raining?
I didn't. I slipped getting the boat out of the water.
Boat?
Bye!
George?
Hey, it's Christy with Ocala Mac and PC Repair and Ocala Guest Wi-Fi to let you know we have you covered. We are the only local certified Apple and Microsoft computer company in Ocala. We are family owned and operated. From mobile repair to wireless networks, viruses, new systems, or security cameras, we do it all. Check us out online, ocalamacpc.com, or give us a call, 352-566-8324.
Tell them Nick, Madison, or Mason sent you and get free diagnostic.
Get your internet telephone service from the company that brought affordable internet service to Ocala in the first place. All is Safe is a sister company of Ocala Guest Wi-Fi, a company you've known and trusted for all your internet needs. Whether you need a phone or hundreds, we've got the products and services to meet your needs both now and in the future. Our plans include everything from local and long-distance calling to equipment maintenance and even software upgrades. You can count on All is Safe to give you cost certainty knowing that your bill will be the same next week, next month, or even next year. Call 352-450-8647 today to learn how to cut your monthly telephone bill up to 60%.
What you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Get checked for skin cancer right now because you may not even know you have it. Because teens are addicted to the sun-kissed glow from tanning beds. If you naturally wake up on your own after just 6 hours of sleep, meaning without using an alarm, then you're probably getting all the rest your body needs. We should all be eating a lot more onions. That's because they're packed with fermentable carbohydrates. Fermentable carbs can do everything from help us lose weight to fight deadly diseases.
Intelligence for your life. Don't miss this stuff.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
To Navy Yard, where a gunman opened fire this morning, killing 12 people, the gunman among the dead. Office workers in the heavily guarded military facility came under fire. The dead shooter described as a former Navy officer in his 50s, who recently had his status changed. The cleanup is underway in parts of Colorado as helicopter search teams fan out to rescue hundreds still stranded by floodwaters. The list of those unaccounted for is slowly shrinking. The mother of a former Florida A&M University football player who was shot and killed by a police officer while knocking on doors this weekend seeking help after a car crash says she forgives the officer. Though, says Georgia Farrell, you caused a great loss to my heart. Progress slower than expected as engineers lift the hull of that shipwrecked Costa Concordia off an Italian reef. This is ABC News.
I will never forget the day my son Jeremy told me he hated me and slammed the door in my face. I'm behavioral therapist Janet Lehman. Behavior problems can turn the child you love and your life into a nightmare. That's why my husband James and I created the Total Transformation, the step-by-step program that shows you how to fix the worst behavior problems and get your child to respect and listen to you again. No matter what the behavior, defiance, backtalk, angry outbursts, disrespect, we can help you stop it. Now you can get the Total Transformation for free. All you need to do is get the program and let us know how it works for you. You can keep it forever for free.
Limited number of free programs available. Call now 1-888-534-3605. 1-888-534-3605. That's 1-888-534-3605. 1-888-534-3605.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry. We didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on. Stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
All right, like the man said, it's hour two of the program called The Voice of Ocala on a Monday afternoon. Kind of taking it in stride today. It's a little bit warm out, but, you know, fall's on the way, so pretty soon won't be quite so bad. Humidity won't be so bad, and Ocala's a great time to be, a big place to be during late October all the way through almost to May. So we got our good months coming up. I like it. I love this weather when it gets a little bit cooler, a little bit warm right now. Got to keep my air conditioning down around 73 or 72. My wife keeps turning it up to 75. And when the sun comes in on our side, you've been in my house, JJ, you have glass on that one side, yes. And, you know, it gets a little toasty over there. And so, and I like it cool at night. So my bill goes up, but I got it.
Yeah, it's tough to cool down 17 bedrooms. Eight baths.
No, 17 bathrooms, yeah. JJ. Yeah, that's, anyway, so it's a small little house, but it's just tough to cool it. But coming up in this hour, I'll tell you about a different kind of Miss America, kind of surprise folks. In the Miss America contest. In sports, talk about a great legendary player at Florida who passed away. And we'll be joined by Hubert Mizell, TB20. Football over the weekend. JJ, did you have a good weekend?
I didn't leave the couch for 2 days.
Buddy. I know. I was kind of a Mayweather couch potato.
Mayweather fight started so
I did not watch
like
it.
1
we'll have to give us an update in the sports hour. But I'm thinking, well, why'd I bother watching a fight? I know he's going to win.
But that was the thing, though.
What was
you weren't thing? Exactly sure if Canelo,
sure.
You know.
JJ, so you just know enough to be ignorant like I do? You just don't worry
No,
about
I just
it.
Enjoy watching the best fighter in
do.
The world.
I understand that. It's like watching Tiger Woods when he's really playing great golf. I get that. And I do like boxing, but and I didn't watch it. But a lot of you're right. It was definitely a weekend for couch potatoes. The bad news, the horrible news out of Washington, D.C., which you heard about today with the shooting at the naval base there. The last count we got was 12 dead, including one of the shooters. They're believed to be multiple shooters. We don't know. It's a lot of confusion there about what happened in Washington. Don't know why the guy was identified as Alexis. What was his name?
Aaron Alexis.
What's Aaron? Whatever. Anyway, so
A-A-R-O-N.
I think the description I got of him, that he was not a former Navy man, but he was a contract worker. So
they've adjusted that now to say that he was a 34-year-old civilian contract worker from Texas.
Yeah, Fort Worth, Texas. So, and you wonder what in the world was he thinking about when he got involved in a shootout. And the report you read earlier, in fact, if you have it, about apparently it was a sniper from the fourth floor who shot down in a cafeteria full of people. That's got to be awful. What a terrible.
Yeah, they're saying now that it was that it took place that a person was shooting from the fourth floor, like open hallway area down into the first floor cafeteria where people were getting their morning coffee and danishes and stuff
like that.
This
is getting to be, I mean, we don't know the total yet of the fatalities. Now, we talk about Boston being horrible. It was just a different kind of thing. It was obviously someone connected to, I won't say Al-Qaeda, but there's an act of terrorism. This apparently was not. But the numbers are getting up there now where we're going to have more dead in this naval base shooting than we had in Boston. What was the Boston number? I forgot.
Two.
Was it just two fatalities overall? A lot more injured, though, with the ball.
It doesn't take much guts to shoot somebody from, you know, miles away and just.
Well, obviously, as the president called him, act of cowardly
sure.
act, which is, you know, and you wonder what in the world is going on there. So, anyway, anything that happens there, Tom will keep you updated on that. In this hour, Dr. Buddy's in the house, and we're going to tell you about the Miss America contest, a little bit different kind of Miss America. The Forbes list has changed a bit. The richest people, the Forbes 400. Some folks on there that you didn't expect, and some folks dropped off, including a person very closely connected to Oklahoma State University, which, by the way, that story is beginning to lose steam. A lot of people
noticed that. I went on SportsIllustrated.com today, and it was still on the front. I'm just like, come on, y'all.
One guy posted.
Let's get over this.
One guy posted that the sex was ridiculous. Said, all they describe was what goes on in every college.
Yeah,
you know. So
I was like waiting to hear some real interesting
stuff,
50
right?
Shades of Grey type stuff, buddy.
Yeah.
Instead, it was like they had sex with the hostesses.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, like, that's brand new. Yeah. Anyway, so we'll catch up with that. Meanwhile, Miss America, what is your typical picture in your mind of Miss America? If you go back to the prototypical Miss America, you go back to the beauty queens, the iconic beauty queens. And to me, if you go way back, there's one or two that set the standard for all of women to the way they looked. I mean, just the pinup girls.
What was her name? Lee, the lady that, she was on Barnaby Jones. She was with Buddy B. Abbott on Barnaby Jones. She was Miss America like 51.
From Mississippi.
50 or 51. Lee.
I know you're talking about
that. That's always the image I get when I think of Miss America.
I think of Marilyn Monroe. I think of people like that, you know, who are blonde.
And who was the girl on CBS Sports that was a Miss America that worked for
some Kentucky.
She worked for CBS Sports in the late 70s.
Phyllis, she was on the NFL Today.
Right, NFL Today with Brent Musburger. Yeah. Phyllis, I want to say Phyllis George.
Her husband was governor of Kentucky.
Phyllis George, right?
Yes, it was Phyllis. I thought you were going to say Phyllis Diller.
No, Phyllis George.
Phyllis
George,
yeah.
Not Miss America.
But you think about Miss America, I mean, whatever your image is, and we all got different images, but you don't expect.
Catherine Webb.
Yeah, boy, she's a beauty. But so this time, for the first time, America's top beauty queen is a woman of Indian origin.
Mm.
How about that? How about that?
I don't know.
It's really sparked some real hateful tweets about her being an Arab terrorist. Now, come on, folks.
Stop it.
Have we not come any further
First
than that?
First off, they're Hindu in India. They're not even, you know, it's not even part of Arab.
Right. Let's get our terrorist cells right. I mean,
but what is it about our small minds automatically? The stereotyping people is the worst thing we can do. I mean, just putting people in a pigeon.
Indian girls can be.
Yeah, one of them. I saw one tweet that says, "I guess Slumdog Millionaire really can happen." I was "Really? What?"
See, her name is Nina Davaluri, 24 years old from New York, who wants to be a doctor.
Of course.
Okay, of course. She said she thought it struck a victory for diversity, and she performed a Bollywood style dance.
Yeah.
So, anyway, I think it's this is America, right? And that includes all races, all people, all, you know, all nationalities.
It's the melting pot, right?
Yeah. So why wouldn't we have, you know?
Well, did you see the army, the girl that's in the army? The Miss America contestant was in the army, and she had the Serenity Prayer tattooed on her back, and then her army, her army company insignia on her shoulder, and she's just getting killed.
Well,
all
she had a great motto too. How you like these guns? No, I'm just kidding.
She's getting killed all in the press though. And
let's go to the phones. Who we got?
Bob.
Hey, Bob. What's up?
I just want to say that we're outsourcing everything to India, so why should
why not Miss America too? Right. That's so very true. Yeah, thank you for that line. It's a pretty good line. We're outsourcing our Miss America, too. So that's the kind of joke you can have. You can have fun with. You know, that works. So appreciate telephone.
Yeah, not terrorist Miss America.
By the way, just anybody wants a quick, when we have an open hour like this, no guests, you're welcome to call. We'll get you on we can. 622-9622.
Climate Control Source Hotline.
What you got?
Update, Aaron Alexis has served in the Navy, but it's still unclear whether he's on active duty or not. Is what the Washington Post is reporting now.
Believed to be the shooter.
Well, he's not on active duty now.
No,
he's inactive.
He's definitely inactive for sure. So.
But the Washington Post is reporting that he has served in the Navy, but it's unclear whether he's still on active duty.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks for that update. Okay. We'll take a break. Come back. I think the doctor's in, isn't he?
The doctor is here.
The doctor is here. He's got lots of quips for you guys. So stay tuned. Coming up next, Dr. Buddy right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
This is Marion County Sheriff Chris Blair's answer to a question posed by Buddy Martin.
If I had to rank top three types of crimes that you're going and you're dealt with, but after drugs, what are the other two or three that you guys would say take up most of your resources and your time?
Well, number one, I mean, you know, certainly drugs is what's leading all crime. With the exception of homicide, where you may have a domestic violent type case and a husband kills the wife or vice versa. The ones that take time are the burglaries, the thefts, you know, the auto burglaries.
That reprise of Ask the Cops was proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. Be sure to tune in to Ask the Cops the second and fourth Friday of every month during the 4 o'clock hour on the Voice of Ocala.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
WOCA, keeping you in touch with Ocala.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440 or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Ocala Radio, WOCA.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala. Real quick, an update on the Naval Yard shootings. As you know, 8:20 this morning, a man opened fire, or multiple men opened fire. That's really not confirmed yet one way or the other. From the fourth floor mezzanine area into a morning cafeteria down on the first floor. There's 12 confirmed dead, including one of the shooters. There's still an active search for a second man of interest. They don't know whether he was actual shooter or not, but they're looking for him. The deceased shooter is Aaron Alexis. The Washington Post says he served in the Navy, but it's unclear whether he's still on active duty. He's 34 years old from Fort Worth, Texas. There are three patients that are in the hospital in Washington with shot gunshot wounds to the leg, the abdomen, and the head and arm, one victim head and arm. According to USA Today, all three victims have asked about their colleagues and are concerned for their well-being. The first patient, the one that was shot in the leg, is now in surgery, according to the hospital. All three are alert, even though they're in critical condition. They're alert and expected to survive the shootings. So, shooting at 8:20 this morning, 12 confirmed dead, including the gunman, at the Navy Yard in Washington, D.C., approximately 4 miles from the White House, buddy.
Yep.
Aaron Alexis, 34 years old from Fort Worth, Texas, a gunman that is now deceased.
Yep. Washington Mayor Vincent Gray said he was shot during the exchange with a Metro police officer, and he says, as far as they know, it's an isolated incident. They don't know any motive at this point in time. Before we go to Dr. Buddy, you have a phone call?
Yes, Hugh on the beauty pageants.
How are you, Hugh?
Well, pretty good, you guys, and how are you doing?
Very good, sir. Not very happy about what's happening in our nation's capital today.
Yeah, you know, we just get away from something, and kind of everything gets back to normal, and bang, you get hit with it again.
Yes,
it just
seems
it's
always some kind of tragedy going on.
It, always something going on, yeah. See, talk about the beauty pageant. Now, yeah. I watched it last night. Now, they made a big deal about that woman that had the tattoo.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not against tattoos, but that tattoo was bad. I don't. She had, was like, it? It was like writing, you know, or something. But
was it across her rib?
Yeah,
right?
it was a serenity prayer, Hugh, on her rib. On her rib.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
It was a serenity. I see tattoos like, you know, like a rose or mom or dad or Popeye or something, but not that. I mean, that just, I know I was distracting. I didn't think it was very nice.
I'm looking at it
nice.
Right now, buddy.
What?
I'm looking at it right now.
Yeah.
I think it's sexy.
See, maybe we're just too old. I agree with you.
Yeah, I guess
you.
So.
JJ, of course, JJ's tatted up pretty good himself.
Well,
you need to ask him about that tattoo he's got.
It's big. It's bigger than what I would expect for somebody who's doing the Miss America. It's her whole.
It covered too much leg. Yeah, it was just too much. I watched the bathing suit deal last night.
Yeah.
And after a while you get like
suits,
go into a trance. They all look alike after a while. You know what I mean?
Some beautiful ladies, I'll say that. I didn't watch it.
Not that I was going to go to sleep or anything, but I was kind of like hypnotized. You know.
I think it was a little different. It's not hypnotized. Mesmerized, more like it.
Memorized. Yeah,
I'm going to tell you a little bit about how much time we spend today looking at ladies here in a minute on my Dr. Buddy segment, so stay tuned for that. And
okay, very good. Okay, thank you very much, you guys. Good programming again, and I haven't been down to see you guys yet, but I'm coming down sooner or later. I'll get down there.
We got you. See you warm. Come on in. All right, you appreciate it. One of our loyal callers, you. Okay, I think it's time for Barry White.
We've got it to
great music.
Got to get
myself on the shoulders.
Got to get you in the mood. Go, Barry.
My first, my last, my everything.
Everybody's singing in the studio. JJ's trying to sing.
And the answer to.
Oh, boy. A little romance in the air right there. Dr. Buddy's in the house helping you with your relationship. If you're having a problem with your relationships, we can help you. Dr. Buddy is in the house. This is primarily aimed at guys today, although we do certainly want to take care of the ladies as well. This is just some factoids, a little few quips you should know to be able to better handle your relationship. After all these thousands of years, men and women still don't get each other. Isn't it amazing? I can speak of one who's been married 118 years, and we still struggle sometimes. So,
men are from Mars, women are from Venus,
there you go.
Buddy.
I don't know if you're sure. Maybe from Pluto. I'm not sure, but here we go. Here's a little factoid you should know. 70% of women ask questions in which they already know the answer to. So just simply tell her the truth to start with. That's the best thing. So remember, guys, they know the answer.
So they're setting you up.
They're setting you up. So tell the truth. Number two, a little advice. We may love the wrong person, cry for the wrong person, but one thing is sure. Mistakes help us find the right person. Nothing personal, Tom. Nothing personal.
Wow.
I'm just saying. Just tell it like it is here. Dr. Buddy does not mince words when it comes to relationships, okay? If you can't handle it.
And we have to be able to accept we're having relationship problems.
You have to accept
problems,
that, or you can never be helped. So
exactly.
If you don't accept them, Listen to Dr. Buddy, and he will make your life a lot happier.
That's why I'm all ears.
You're always. JJ is a very attentive listener. He takes notes. he plays back the tapes at night. So, you know, he's a good goodness. Student. You know what? And in about 30 years,
he'll see.
He'll still be struggling. All right, number three. You guys sit here looking at the pretty ladies coming by the window all day long. They come walking by here.
Well, of course. It's a mall, buddy. Pretty women are going to walk by.
How much time a day do you think? Now, just be honest. The average male spends looking at women. How many hours?
That lady said a lot.
Hours?
How much time? No, think about it. Now, JJ, it could be hours.
Well, I mean, you actually just said hours, so I wasn't going to say that. I'm going to say 30 minutes.
How much time a day do you think?
No, I'm going to say 45 minutes.
45 minutes?
Yeah.
JJ, why would you say 45 minutes?
I don't know. I don't think it's up to an hour.
JJ, your favorite number is what?
47.
Why didn't you say that instead? No. All right, so you say 45, huh? Yeah. Think about it. I thought actually staring at somebody.
Yeah.
45 minutes?
Well, think about it.
No.
TV.
No, real live women.
No.
Think about it. Now, I'm talking about, you're actually looking at women for 45 minutes.
Can it be somebody
a day?
That you're with? No. Does that count?
Yeah. It could
be. No, buddy, it's a lot longer than that.
You think it's longer?
I'm going to say, if it's with somebody you're with, a few hours.
I'd say.
I'm counting mostly looking at the other women, okay? I'm not thinking about the one.
I'd say an hour and a half, about an hour and 30 minutes.
That's a long time. Think about it. You actually look at women. Am I counting the parade of ladies?
Buddy, I look at women for 3 hours as they walk by this window.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, not all 3 hours.
No,
most of 3 hours.
No, it's a number of time. I'm talking starting the clock once you lock on your eyes. That's when the clock starts.
Right.
Not when you're prowling and scouting. I'm talking about when you're actually looking.
I probably look with my ADHD, but just since you've been talking about this, I probably looked at six women.
All right. Well, here you go. I got to talk to you about choice and selection, by the way. Anyway. All right. And how many women do you think you look at a day? Not counting the one you're with. I'm actually looking at. I didn't say lust. I said look at.
60, 70.
I was
60
about to
or
say
70.
30. 30.
You guys are crazy.
30.
You guys are crazy.
I'm easily attracted by 30 women.
No, I can't get any work out of you guys.
So what's the numbers?
43 minutes a day.
Boom.
The average male spends during at 10 different women.
10.
No, that's ridiculous.
I was right.
Hey, don't ever question Dr. Buddy. Don't ever say he's ridiculous. That's not acceptable.
It's more than 10.
The man has a PhD.
Yeah, you don't question the doctor. All right. Okay, we all know this, but it's something reminding us. You know, sometimes you get a little lonely, you get blues, you get the blues, you're kind of alone. This missing someone and not being able to do anything about it generally makes people moody, easily annoyed, and emotionally frustrated. Well, we all kind of knew that, but sometimes you don't realize why you're moody and frustrated. So sometimes you're just missing somebody. So what do? Pick up the phone, make a telephone call, right? Or text somebody. You can fix those things.
You
got
to talk to other people sometimes.
That's what I do.
I surround myself with my friends.
I just smack somebody upside the head.
Yeah, that's it. Hey, wait. You're saying that you're taking advice from someone besides Dr. Buddy? That's heresy. You're taking advice from your friends over Dr. Buddy?
And I know some of your friends. That is heresy.
All right. You're right, though. Talking it does help it. All right. Okay. Here's the thing about women. You need to know. This is very important, guys. Listen up. This is good advice here. Now, you should be writing this down. You know, when you actually get interested in somebody, you don't know if they're interested in you, et cetera, et cetera. Sometimes you wonder, am I being more interested in her than she is in me? And you don't really know.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? The facts are women tend to underestimate men's interest in them. And men tend to overestimate women's interest in them.
So explain that.
Well, what it means is that men think the ladies are all
about them.
And really, they're not. But women don't get it sometimes.
When a guy's all about you.
Like the women sometimes don't catch it. I would think it'd be the opposite.
Opposite, me too.
Dr. Buddy may have to check that research. It's not sounding right in our meter here. You know, it's just. I would think it'd be the other way around, but no. This is what our crack research team came up with, JJ. It's the same one that works on factoids and travels around the world for stuff. Okay, here's one that's important. Remember, communication, communication, communication. How many times have I told you that your key to your relationship is all about communication.
Every time.
Every time. Always. Now, JJ, do you talk a lot when you're out with a lady?
To her?
Yeah.
I wouldn't say a lot.
No?
But I listen a lot.
You're a good listener. Know,
yeah.
Tom, you like to talk or listen? Which one do you do?
I like to talk.
You already know. What kind of question is that, buddy? Are you serious?
Are you kidding? Doctor Buddy has no built-in prejudices. Okay. He treats each client the same. Okay. It's a level playing field. I just want to know, do you talk or more? Or she? What would you say the ratio was, Tom, and you talking to your ladies versus them?
80-20.
Oh, man. 80-20. I was going to at least say 70-30. At the most, 70-30. He's not even giving himself that much.
That reminds me of that story about a guy I told you guys once before. He was sitting in a restaurant. It actually happened. And the guy talked about himself for 30 minutes in front of his girlfriend. And he gets through and said, but enough about me. Let's talk about you. What do you think of me?
Exactly.
She's laughing.
Okay with that.
She's laughing and she's brushing her hair
walking
by.
What's that country song, Tom? Want to talk about me?
Yeah, talk about me. It's Toby Keith.
Yeah.
Here's the facts. Women speak nearly 7,000 words a day. Think about that.
Yep.
7,000 words a day. Okay? Men average about 2,000.
Oh, I believe that.
Not these three.
Well, first of all, Buddy hosts a three-hour radio show. He talks a good amount. But, I don't know if I say 2,000 words a day.
You're more like John Wayne. You're fewer words.
I promise you, I say at least 4,000 or 5,000.
Yeah. All right. Well, okay.
Sometimes I talk just to me, just to hear me.
You like you hear some of yourself.
I stand in the mirror and have a conversation just so I know what I'm doing.
Yeah. How do you like it, by the way?
Pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good. All right. Finally, wrapping up on another Dr. Buddy segment. We could go on for more, but we got to wrap it up. Because look at the hundreds of fans gathering outside the window right now.
Take a note.
Look at that note. Sign. Dr. Buddy, we love you. I love you, too. There you go. So here we go.
I feel like college game day over here.
Here we go. We could do that here, you know.
All right. Built by Bed Bath & Beyond.
Good one. Good one. Does this lady know this? I wonder if she knows this. That men average talking 2,000 words a day, and women average talking 7,000. No one's challenging that. No ladies are challenging that.
Because they all know. They talk a lot.
Okay. Well, I was going to say it that way, JJ. Don't ever put down ladies. Okay, finally, this comes from a weird world fact. Now, I hope no ladies are coming by now because they're going to hate me when I say this. But here's an old saying that you can take to the bank. Tell a girl a million times she's not fat, she'll never believe you. Call her fat once and she'll never forget it.
Exactly. Yes.
Yes. I know there's only, one like you. All right. Dr. Buddy's in the house. Take a break. Come back. Tell you about the richest men in the world. It's time to play a little bit of fake or factoids, if the guys are up for it.
I got JJ so easy.
Coming up in sports, we'll talk about that A&M, the game of the century, A&M Alabama. A horrible call by the Zebras. Tom, this is right down your alley.
Oh, it's terrible.
This is awful. This is one of the worst calls I've ever seen in a football game. And it's undeniably wrong. And we'll talk about what's happening with Mac Brown and I'm sorry, Josh is not a happy boy right now.
Do you think he's going to make it?
No.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Well, we'll discuss that in sports. We'll find out. Good topic. Meanwhile, let's take a break. We'll come back with more on Voice of Ocala after this timeout on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Dr. Seaborn Hunt, a board-certified ophthalmologist, is your comprehensive medical, laser, and surgical eye care specialist for Marion, Lake, and Sumter counties. He offers services for cataract surgery, diabetes, glaucoma, macular degeneration, dry eyes, as well as a routine comprehensive eye exam. Call 873-7200 for an appointment today. No referral needed. Dr. Hunt accepts Medicare as well as most insurance plans and files the claims for you. Dr. Hunt has performed thousands of successful procedures. Call Dr. Hunt at 873-7200. That's 873-7200.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, The Source. Recently, I had a great conversation with General Manager Pat Murray on the special events at Country Club of Ocala.
We have a lot of events, special events here that are geared towards the family. Easter comes to mind. We have an Easter bunny who hops around on the driving range. We usually hide somewhere in a neighborhood of 3,000 eggs and turn them loose and let them go harvest the eggs. We have a great family celebration here on the 4th of July where it's a traditional cookout, if you will. And as the sun goes down, the driving range becomes alive with probably one of the better fireworks displays in the area. Breakfast with Santa is a big deal.
Country Club of Ocala, where the Easter Bunny, Santa, and all the children, large and small, are a big deal on every special occasion. For more information, call 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of the Bundy Gator Report right here on The Source.
Hey, I didn't know it rained last night.
Oh, it didn't. Why do you say that?
Because little Johnny's in the backyard playing in that big mud puddle.
Did you leave the hose on?
No, the neighbor borrowed it yesterday.
Wait, is that the side where the septic...
Johnny, get out of there!
Having septic problems? At Mike Scott Plumbing, we can make those septic worries disappear. We can pump your septic tank, repair your drain field, and, if needed, even install a whole new system. At Mike Scott Plumbing, we don't take crap from anyone. We take it from everyone. 237-2888. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Got a garden and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Howdy, folks. RL here to invite you to Dairy Queen for a great new meal. Dairy Queen's now serving three different $5 meals. Hot dogs, chili, cheese, slaw, whatever. Quarter pound with cheese, loaded up any way you like it. Solid filet chicken tenders. And each meal comes with fries, a drink, and a sundae for only $5. You got that right. Nobody beats that deal. A great value and a great meal. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs where they always treat you like kings and queens.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala. On a Monday, the death toll in Washington, where there's been a shooting, now up to 13, just reported by USA Today. So the 13 includes the shooter. Of course, it happened at 8:20 this morning at the naval base in Washington. The shooter has been identified as a former contract worker for the Navy and from Fort Worth, Texas, and there apparently is some dispute about whether he did serve in the Navy or didn't, but he definitely was a contract worker. So we don't know any details other than that. Horrible thing, 13 people killed in a shooting at a naval, and it makes you wonder, how could that happen at a naval base? But Fort Hood had 13 also, as I recall. So it has to be like an inside job for that to happen, because security, otherwise, there's no way to get past them. So we'll keep you updated. That's the latest figure in the Washington, D.C. shooting at the naval base. 13 dead now in Washington.
Makes, you know, a young person, I'm way too old for this, but, you know, if you're 16, 17, thinking about joining the military, you see all these ex-military guys coming, you know, freaking out, doing crazy stuff like this.
Yeah.
you definitely don't want to join.
Well, I mean, somebody's got to do it. And, you know, they weren't the one first ones to get post-disorder stress syndrome that happened to the greatest generation. They came back. I had uncles and people who tossed and turned at nighttime and said had nightmares. And it's a horrible, war is a horrible thing, you know. And people get messed up. And it's been going on for centuries, you know. And but there, we need soldiers to defend us. And they're brave, just like we need policemen and firemen to defend us in many ways. So they're the first line of defense for us. And it's how do you deal with it? But you're right. It's not an attractive – but there are some people born to serve as a warrior. They're just born to be soldiers. That's how – and sailors and whatever you want to call them. Born to fly. They're just made that way. And thank God for them, because without them, we'd be in a lot of trouble. So our hearts go out to the families connected to this thing. But you certainly wouldn't think as you went to work today in a naval base in Washington, D.C., that you had a family member would be killed.
Absolutely not.
Crazy.
You'd think that's one of the safest places to be.
You certainly think so. All right, I'm going to get this Forbes list I've been talking about. Forbes comes out with their richest list every year, the Forbes 400. And out of the 400 this year, 34 fell off the list, including Broadcom co-founder. I don't know what Broadcom is. Co-founder Henry Nicholas and Rackspace hosting chairman Graham Weston. I don't know him either. Were knocked off by their company's slumping stock prices.
I'm sure they're still doing fine, buddy.
Oh, I'm just because they're, yeah, I don't think there'll be any charitable dinners for them. Of the 34 drop-offs, six of them died, including the guy who invented Dolby. You know what Adobe is?
Adobe on the computer?
Dolby. Dolby. It's a for noise. No. It's a noise.
Surround sound.
Right.
It's sound.
And it's noise reduction, too. It's what makes things sound so good. He's a founder of Dolby Laboratories. Ray Dolby, he died September 12th at age 80 after suffering Alzheimer's disease. One of the most notable drop-offs, T. Boone Pickens.
Bad week for Oklahoma State.
Was it ever. Falling natural gas prices made Pickens' wind energy investments tank in value. He's begging to win. He said in MSNBC, he said that he had lost his ASS off in the wind business. Pickens' net worth fell under the $1 billion mark for the first time since 2005 to only an estimated $950 million.
Loser.
So
the man said he gave over $500 million so far to
and
the
said
Oklahoma
he was glad,
State.
He was glad to do it. It was worth every penny.
So, that's a man who loves his college football, man.
Okay, you know this five-hour energy drink thing?
Yes.
The guy's name is Manoj Bhargava.
Yeah, I just saw a thing on
He apparently, they dropped off after debuting on the list with a net worth of $1.5 billion.
I hate
that. Bhargava saw his net worth more than halved to $800 million. Yeah. I mean, how could we have to ask Laurie sometime, but, you know, that stuff can't be good for you.
Absolutely not.
I mean, well, I don't
say it, and you know Laurie.
Jim Fury drinks it, you know. That's
They say it's all the difference between it and Red Bull is it's all from all natural extracts and everything, who cares?
Yeah, wow.
Sales it's like of cocaine in a bottle.
Yeah. Sales of five-hour energy drinks have been falling, leading Forbes to a slashed evaluation of his living essentials, five-hour energy parent firm. So that's
he's doing terrible. He's only worth $800 million.
Yeah, exactly.
But, I mean, for your company to just be cut in half like that.
All right, guys, it's time to play fake or factoid. You ready to go?
Let's do it.
Okay, there's three of these are made up, okay? Here we go. Tom, disclaimer, please.
Any wrong or right answers are not the responsibility of this radio station, J.J. LaSalva or Tom Schmitz. All the answers are Buddy Martin and Buddy Martin's alone, whether they're wrong or right.
Let me give you a new announcer. It's not fast enough. All right. Here we go. Fake or factoid. Number one, Michelle Obama, also born in Hawaii, but has a birth certificate to prove it.
Fake.
Fake, you say?
Yeah.
Fake.
You're both correct. Number two. Dr. Awkward, spelled backwards, is Dr. Awkward. You got 5 seconds.
Fact.
Yeah.
You're both right. Okay, here's one for you. The roar of the T-Rex in the movie Jurassic Park was made by combining the sounds of a baby elephant, alligator, and a tiger.
True.
Yes.
You're correct. You're on fire. 3 for 3. This can't last. Florida has nearly 22 million people.
No.
Fact.
Thomas Wright's 19.2.
Oh, give me a break.
It's a little bit, but hey, I, you know, Can't all be Kimmies. All right, here's one for you. The University of Mississippi is home to the only federally legal marijuana farm and is run by the government.
I'm going to say not true. I feel like that's somewhere else.
Fact.
JJ?
Untrue.
It's two misses, JJ.
Dang. Ole Miss, huh?
I just watched something about that, too, on TV.
Laughing for an hour can burn as many calories as lifting weights for 30 minutes.
Oh, my God. There's no way that's true. I'm going to say not true.
True.
JJ, you're out.
Oh, my God. I started out hot.
And by the way, I still haven't missed one.
3-0. And let's see. JJ, you can, after Tom guesses, you can just do an exhibition match, okay? Okay, you ready?
How many we got left?
All for you. Hawaii has the second lowest rate of obesity in the U.S.
False.
True.
Has the highest rate of obesity.
No, that's Mississippi. You missed.
Tom has got his first miss. It does have the second lowest.
Right.
Okay. Octopuses are very smart. They can even use their tentacles to unscrew the lid of a jar.
True.
I've seen something like that, I'm sure. I've seen them pick football games
before.
Which
way are you going?
True.
I'm going to say true.
You're right, both of you. All right. Here's a couple more. George Washington refused to accept a salary while he was in office as president.
Fact.
Yeah, I'll follow Tom.
Correct. A couple more. Thomas Jefferson spent many years abroad in Germany and Switzerland.
False.
True.
It's false. It was France.
Yeah.
So, Tom, you did well. I think that's all.
I only missed one.
You did well. You got them all but one. Which one did you not miss? I forgot.
The third one from the last.
Hawaii.
Okay.
But you got to know people in Hawaii are trying to stay looking fresh and healthy. They're on the beach.
I just thought of Samoa, close to Hawaii.
They're bigger dudes.
All the stereotype, right?
You know what one of their number one meat dishes is a delicacy over there is spam.
Oh, yeah, and they serve spam in Walmart or
in McDonald's.
That,
right. So any state that spam is your number one meat to eat, how are you the second lowest obesity? You know what I mean?
Yeah. I thought sure the T-Rex might throw you, and maybe the octopuses might throw you. But
I always thought it was called octopi, buddy.
This is the way it's written. I read it down. It is all called octopi. By the way, I could have thrown in a little ringer there for you on an elephant, alligator, and tiger. I could have said a dog, and that would have been unfair. You know, cause instead of saying tiger, I could have said dog, and you got it wrong. But I didn't. I want you to play
fair.
You
have integrity.
I have integrity. I want to make these factoids, believable. And good job, Tom.
Well, that's like two I said in a row that he wants to make factoids believable.
Yeah, exactly. It's amazing factors. I'm always amazed at those.
Though, just by being the Triviaator and all, I probably win
you
these more dollars?
It's a profession for you. You should take some of these and actually use them and turn them around saying,
Speaking of trivia, have you been watching the Million Second Quiz?
What is that?
It's the Ryan Seacrest. I watched a half of it one time.
They started it last Sunday morning at 8 a.m., JJ, and it goes 24 hours a day. Till they hit a million seconds.
No, I haven't hit that one now. I've watched Ryan Seacrest. So what's that called?
That's the Ryan Seacrest.
That goes all day?
They only show you 1 hour a day of it on TV, but it goes nonstop all day.
What do they do?
You and another person sit across from each other, and you have 300 seconds that you have a trivia battle back and forth. Ryan Seacrest asking questions, and you get points for everyone you get right, whoever's got the most points at the end of it. And you get $10. You get $10 a second while you're sitting in the chair.
Yeah, that's okay. A weird looking chair,
right? And at the end, and it's all outdoors. It's outdoors in a covered area right outside in downtown New York City.
What's it called? A million second.
Million second quiz. It's got two more days to go, I think. Tonight and tomorrow night.
You tell me.
Yeah.
I'm not a quiz show person.
How long is a million seconds?
10 days. Okay. Right at 10 days.
Hmm.
Interesting.
And so
a challenge of trivia and endurance.
Yeah.
NBC, you've really lost.
Yeah, because they play. I mean, literally, they're playing at 3 o'clock in the morning. They're doing trivia.
Yeah, that stinks. Live tonight at 8. Nobody
right.
will watch.
Seacrest only, by the way, does the 1 hour live. Some other dope does the rest.
I'm assuming Ryan Seacrest isn't sitting outside for 10 days straight asking trivial questions.
That's not happening. All right, time to take a break. Come back. We'll update you on the shooting in Washington, D.C. Sports coming up. Lots to talk about in the Sports Hour, including the death of a legendary Gator. and we'll review the weekend and the pro football schedule for tonight and this week, and give our thoughts on a few people, including Johnny Manziel. It may be time to give him a name. We'll tell you that later after this timeout on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. Source.
Dr. Seaborn Hunt, a board-certified ophthalmologist in Ocala, offers advanced cataract surgery with laser astigmatism correction to reduce and potentially eliminate your dependence on glasses for both distance and near vision and some areas in between. If you have cataracts or need a second opinion to discuss your lens implant options and determine if you're a candidate for precision multifocal lens implant, call Dr. Hunt's office to set up an appointment to see if you qualify for the upgraded lens. Call Dr. Seaborn Hunt's office today for an appointment. 873-7200. That's 873-7200.
Dry, itchy, scaly skin? Do you have psoriasis? Consider joining our research study. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study evaluating the effectiveness of investigational combination of two study medications for moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. You may qualify if you're between the ages of 18 and 75 and have been diagnosed with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis for at least 6 months. For more information, please call Renstar in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Qualified participants may receive study-related medical care and study medication. Compensation for time and travel may also be provided. To find out more information about this psoriasis study, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. That's 352-629-5800. Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Phil Bonds, Undersecretary of the U.S. Department of Commerce for Technology. He's coming out to speak to us about the internet sales tax issue and how this federal legislation will affect Florida businesses.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Carol Ann Baldwin will be on the air answering your questions about your lawns and your garden on her show, You've Got a Garden.
Stacey McDonough is the Regional Director for the American Heart Association of Marion County. Pam Michelle is the Vice President and Chief Nursing Officer at Monroe Regional Medical Center. They'll be in the studio speaking about the 2013 Marion County Heart Walk on October the 5th.
And then Joe Reichel will be in the studio talking about what he does over at Damage Control Services to put people's houses and homes back together.
Greg Malik spent 29 years at the Will Rogers Museum and Birthplace as curator, manager, and associate director. He'll be speaking at the Bellevue Public Library on September 19th about the life and legacy of Will Rogers.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need too. My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck.
Yep,
we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine, featuring local businesses and issues and written by local volunteers. Lady Lake Magazine has become a must-read in Marion, Lake, and Sumter counties, audited by Circulation Verification Council and serving the area for 23 years. Plus, Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. All we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 352-804-1223 and pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala. Update real quick on the Navy Yard shootings. Now there's 13 confirmed dead, including one shooter. They're still searching for a second gunman. All this took place about 8:20 this morning at the Naval Yard as gunmen opened fire from a fourth-floor mezzanine area into an open-area first-floor cafeteria where people were getting their morning coffee and danishes. 13 now confirmed dead. one of them being the one shooter, and they're searching for a second person of interest in the shootings that took place at the Naval Yard in Washington, D.C., about 4 miles from the White House early this morning.
Yeah, Chief Kathy Lanier says police looking for a black man in his 40s wearing an olive military-style uniform. So that's the latest stuff. Apparently, Aaron Alexis served in the Navy, but it's unclear whether he was still on active duty or not. They're trying to sort that out. So much confusion there.
There's a live press conference going on right now on Fox News.
Bits and pieces keep coming out on the story, which is, as Tom said, broke at 8:20 this morning. And it's just so many questions like, why in the world would a person do this? Why? Who is this person? What made him so upset, or did he have a mission? What motivated this shooting? I mean, you got to know that he didn't think he could get out alive, you know? And it just doesn't make any sense. But then on the other hand, if it was a lone gunman and you could think of a guy could be a nut job, but now we're talking about two people. So now it's more like a mission for somebody to do this, and you think, what could be going on there, you know? And there was a lot of horror. You know, Hugh said it well. We let it pass, but it just seems like we go from tragedy to tragedy in this country. You know, if it's not Newtown, Connecticut, you know, or it's Ariel Castro, it's just one horrible story after another, and you begin to wonder what is up with this world, these people in this world. What's going on? Is the Earth off its axis? No wonder a lot of people think this is the end times. You know, there's all this crazy stuff going on. So anyway, we got news coming up the next hour on this ridiculous ending of this Wisconsin-Arizona State game. Something has been taking place following. If you haven't seen it, be sure and check out this video of what happened to the Badgers in this situation. Stolen, literally stolen from them.
Yes, so, and they were undefeated, and they play a schedule where they could go undefeated the rest of the season. That would be massive.
Yeah, really huge.
It was a chip shot field goal.
Yes, and you know, here's the thing about it, is that there are going to be mistakes, all right? I can understand a blown call. This is so blatant.
Yeah, there wasn't even like a live action play, where you might miss it. It was
a
right
third grader could have gotten this
exactly.
Right. You know, this is not like it takes a Mensa person to be able to get this. So it's very disturbing, the kind of thing that no wonder officials get so get criticized so much when this kind of stuff happens. So we'll tell you what the fate of those people are, and in the sports hour also. I know we all watched Johnny Manziel, an amazing performance he put out there. And although his team didn't win, certainly I think we have a new respect. And yet, what are the pros saying about him? Well, you'll never guess what. It's just like there's this thing called let's rip on the collegiate icons and then whoever it is. So all that coming up next. Be sure to stay tuned. Lots coming your way. Anything happens in the Washington shooting, we'll update you on that. Listening to the program called The Voice of Ocala on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class, or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
Requires bank approval. Vehicle purchase price of fixed rate allowance.
Yahoo! Kids are back in school and report cards are right around the corner. I've got old cars shaking in their boots because I'm flunking clunkers and junkers this month.
Hey, Professor Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. What's a smart plan to keep you from flunking out in a car that can't make the grade?
This week, trade in and save more. Get the appraised value of your old car plus up to $4,500 off a nicer, newer car.
Stuck in bad credit detention? Our For the People credit approval process wants to help everyone, even if you've been turned down before.
I vow that no car will be left behind.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales today.
Yes, during our old car report card event, you'll get up to $4,500 off a nicer, newer car, plus the appraised value of your old car. But hurry, my old car report card event ends September 30th, or after we've helped 67 students pass the test in a nicer, newer car. My name is Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige!
This is Austin Tavern reminding you to stay in contact with us at WOCA. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Voice of Ocala. Make sure to become a friend of our Facebook page and call us at 622-9622.
Right here since 1957, we're WOCA, News Talk 1370.
The Corkscrew Winery in downtown Ocala is having a grape stomp Saturday, September 21st from 5 to 7 p.m. The cost is only $25, and that includes the grape stomp experience, a glass of wine, and light finger food. Plus, you bottle and take home a finished wine. The Corkscrew Winery is located at 16 Southwest Broadway in historic downtown Ocala. Space is limited and reservations are required, so call today, 352-402-0158. That's 352-402-0158.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the Links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need too. My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
yep,
truck.
Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking the big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3, exclusively on WOCA The Source.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
Police continue to search for a possible second shooter at the Washington Navy Yard, where 13 people are now confirmed dead following this morning's massacre, including a gunman identified as 34-year-old Aaron Alexis from Fort Worth, Texas. Police are asking people to remain in their homes tonight. The Washington Nationals baseball game has been postponed. Colorado residents forced out of their homes by the floods are being told to register with FEMA as soon as possible. Meanwhile, a search and rescue mission for those stranded by the floodwaters is being expanded. The 12-year-old Florida girl, who authorities say committed suicide after being bullied online, was mourned at a funeral service today. Among the 250 people at Rebecca Sedgwick's funeral, many wore T-shirts with anti-bullying slogans. Glendale, California School District trying to stop cyberbullying by watching what students post on social media sites This is ABC News.
They call me Murphy, and I'm a service tech at Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center. It was 9:30 on a Saturday morning, and a Kona Blue Mustang drove in.
I'm due for a tire rotation.
I poured her coffee, black. She hopped on Wi-Fi, and I got to work. I inflated, rotated, and aligned the tires. Multi-point inspection looked good. Took a half hour, tops.
With a full range of services, great prices on 13 name brand tires, and no appointment necessary, Quick Lane is ready to serve. Visit quicklane.com.
In mid-sized companies, the left hand needs to know what the right hand is doing. When they do, business can take on a whole new rhythm, especially with IBM Smart Cloud Engage Advanced. It combines communities, web meetings, and file sharing with business-grade email in one security-rich environment, making it the smarter way to collaborate. Register now for your 60-day free trial at ibm.com/engines/engage.
I'm a shot. 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.